Welcome to AIIMS India's online classes. Today, from our science subject, we are going to start a new chapter that is Earth and Universe. Okay, children, so we are going to learn about our planet on which we are living, that is Earth, and also about the sky, the beautiful sky, what we see every day in the day and in the night. So what are all there in the sky? Nothing but the universe. So we are going to learn about that. So before going to the lesson, children, so let us just know so what we are going to learn from this chapter. So we are going to learn about the solar system, the satellites, stars, and also the movements of the earth. Clear? So this is our checklist. You have got some pictures which are reflecting the day and night. Okay, so let us see what is that. When we look at the night sky, we see the moon, planets, and stars. Stars twinkle in the night sky, but planets do not. In the daytime, we see the sun in the sky. Yes or no? So when we just look at the sky in the night, okay, in the night, what do we see? You see the moon, okay, planets and stars. Okay, children, so here we will not be able to see the planets. They are planets in the sky, but we cannot see the planets. Only with the help of some special instruments like telescope and so, we will be able to see. But normally, when you just raise your head up and look at the sky in the night, you can see the moon and also the stars. And how are the stars, children? Stars are very bright. They twinkle. They twinkle. They shine. They twinkle. They are very bright. Okay, in that dark sky, in the dark sky, especially at the nights. Okay, but planets, because they cannot shine, they do not have light on their own, we will not be able to see the planets. Okay, so what these planets do, they reflect the light of the sun. Suppose here our planet Earth is there. Okay, so this Earth will be receiving the light from the sun. As the star has got light, planets do not have the light. No, sun is also a star. It is a very big star. Okay, children? So planets receive the light from the sun. So when they revolve around the sun, they get the light from the sun. So planets are not able to see in the night because they do not twinkle like the stars. And in the daytime, we can see the sun in the sky. No, in the day, we can see the sun with different shades. No, morning sun, afternoon sun, evening sun. Okay, so the sunrise, the sunset, and mid-afternoon sun. So we can see the sun in the sky. Again, in this chapter, let us learn more about the sun, moon, stars, and planets. See, we are going to have a clear picture of this sun, moon, stars, and planets in this chapter. Okay, children? Now, so first, we'll start with the solar system. Solar system. What is this solar system? The sun, the eight planets, their moons, and the dwarf planets together, they are the solar system. Okay, so they form the solar system. This is FORM, children. So what is the solar system? What all you have in the solar system? So we'll be having the sun, we'll be having the eight planets. So we are having eight planets. No, all that eight planets, and we also have moon. And we also have dwarf planets. So planets, normally what we count, the eight planets are big in size. Okay, children. And apart from that, we also have some very small planets. Dwarf is very small planets. all together, all this together, they are going to form the solar system. All this together are called as the solar system. Clear, children? What is the solar system? The sun, 8 planets, moon, and also the dwarf planets all together are called as solar system. And the planets revolve around the sun in their fixed paths called orbits. So what do the planets do? They are going to revolve around the sun. They are going to travel around the sun. Suppose this is the sun, children, in the center. All the eight planets, okay, they are going to travel around the sun. That is nothing but revolution. We call it as revolution, revolving. Okay, so this revolution around the sun in their fixed path. What is the path? Path is a way. So normally when we step out from our house, so we are going to go for a shop or a school, anywhere. No, what on the way which we walk or we travel, that way is called as a path. We call it as a path. Okay, children? So as these planets are revolving around the sun in their fixed path, this is fixed. There is no change in this way. Suppose if you are going to start, a planet is going to start its journey from here, it is going to travel from this and then it's going to end here. Again it starts here and it's going to end here. So that is just taking round and round and round and round. Okay, traveling around the planet in a fixed way. That is why we call it as a fixed path. And we call that particular way as orbits. What do we call it as? We call it as orbits. Clear, children? So what is an orbit? The planets which they revolve around the sun in their fixed path is called as an orbit. Okay. And the 8 planets nearest to farthest from the sun. So nearest to farthest. So planets are near to the sun. Some are very far to the sun. See here. In this picture, you can have a clear vision of the planets. All the 8 planets here, children. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. The nearest planet is Mercury. And the last farthest planet is the Neptune. Farthest because it is very far away from the sun. Okay, children. So, these are the planets. And the 8 planets, what are they? They are Mercury, Venus, Earth, okay, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. So these are all the 8 planets, children. See, they are of different sizes. No, every planet is of different sizes, but all are of in round shape, that is sphere shape only. All are in a ball shape, a round shape, but the size is a little different. Okay, some are small, some are big, some are in a medium size. Okay, children, so now let us learn in detail about each and every planet, children. So before that, we'll just learn about the sun first. The sun is at the center of the solar system. Where is the sun? The sun is at the center of the solar system. See, this is the sun, children. So it is in the center, this one. So these planets, what do? They are going to revolve. Okay, they are going to take rounds around the sun like this. Okay, clear, children? But the sun is in the middle of the solar system. And it is a huge ball of hot gases that continuously gives out heat and light. What does this sun do? It is going to give us heat and light, without which it is very difficult for us to live on this planet Earth. Clear, children? So, because we are having sun and our Earth is revolving around the sun, so here on this planet we in the sense all the living organisms like plants, animals, okay, we are all able to live here because of the heat and light of the sun. Okay children, because earth does not have, planets does not have any light. Okay, so what is this sun? It is a huge ball, a big ball. What does it contain? It contains hot gases. It contains hot gases like hydrogen, helium, okay? And this is going to continuously give out heat and light. Okay, children? Now, so here is science in context. I'll just read it for you. The average distance of the sun from the earth is about 150 million kilometers. Okay, so far away from the earth. And this distance is called one astronomical unit, that is 1 AU. AU is nothing but astronomical unit, okay. An astronomical unit is used for measuring the distance of planets and satellites within the solar systems. So, as we measured the distance of, on the roads in kilometers, children, here. So, like that. So, in the space, in the universe, to measure the distance of planets and the other satellites in the solar system, they are going to measure it in astronomical unit. Okay. Astronomical unit. So 150 million kilometers is equal to one astronomical unit. Okay, children. So this is what we have learned today about the distance between the satellites and also the planets in the solar system. Like how do we measure it? Okay, clear now? Now we learn about the planets one by one. The first planet here, what is it? It is the Mercury. Mercury, okay. So Mercury is the planet nearest to the sun. This planet is nearer to the sun, as we have seen in the picture, children. So this is the first planet and it is very nearer to the sun, and it is the smallest planet in the solar system. So it is the smallest one. So if you see, children, I'll just go back and show you. See, this is Mercury, children, and it is very nearer to the sun also. See here, this one. And it is the smallest. If you observe, among all the planets here, the seven planets, this planet Mercury is very small. So that is why this is the smallest planet in the solar system. Okay. And it does not have any moon. It does not have any moon. So some planets do have moons. As we have got, Earth has got moon. So other planets also are having moons, that is some planets, but this Mercury planet, it does not have any moon, children. Now the second planet is Venus. So Venus is the second planet from the sun. What is this? This is the second planet. This is the first one, this is the second planet, okay. And it is the hottest planet in the solar system. See the speciality of this Venus. It is very hot. The hottest planet in the solar system. And Venus is also called the morning star or evening star, as it can be seen in the sky at dawn and dusk. Okay. So Venus does not have any moon. Okay. So Venus has got two other names also. What are they? Morning star. Morning star. We can call it as morning star, or we can also call it as evening star, because it can be seen in the sky at dawn or dusk. Dawn is sunrise. Dusk is sunset. Okay, that is when the night is going to start in the late evening, that is dusk. Early morning, when the sun is going to rise, it is dawn. Okay, children. And Venus does not have any moon. So here also, Venus is not having any moon. Now comes our third planet, which is the Earth, on which we live. Okay. So Earth is the third planet from the sun, and most of its surface is covered with water. So our planet Earth is mostly covered with water. 3/4 of the earth surface is covered with water. Okay, children. And it is the only planet where life is known to exist. It is the only planet among all the 8 planets, children. Only on earth life is known to exist. We have living things. We have living organisms and we people, animal, birds, plants, all they are living. Okay. And it has one moon revolving around it. So, or we have a moon, children, on earth which is revolving around the earth. It is revolving around the earth, not around the sun. Okay, this you have to remember. And earth is surrounded by a blanket of air called the atmosphere that protects us from the harmful radiations from the sun. So, earth, where it is? It is in the third position from the sun. No, third position, that is the third planet. So, it is going to get the light, it is going to get the heat from the sun. Okay, children. And to get protected from harmful radiations, because the sun is very hot, it produces so much of heat. But because living organisms are there, or life is existing on this planet, so this harmful radiations will cause danger to the living things. Okay, children. So to protect the earth from this harmful radiations, earth is surrounded by a blanket of air. It is surrounded. Now when we sleep, children, we'll just cover our body with a blanket. Why? To protect from the cold, or to protect from the mosquitoes, flies. No, to feel protected. So here also, our earth planet is just covered with a blanket. And a blanket of what? Blanket of air. This blanket is of completely air. And that air is called as the atmosphere. Okay, children. And this atmosphere is going to protect us from the harmful radiations from the sun. See? No. So how are we protected? How is the earth protected, children? By the atmosphere. No. By the atmosphere. And what atmosphere is protecting us from? It is protecting us from the harmful radiations which is received from the sun. Okay, children, now this is about the earth. Understood? Now the fourth planet, children, it is the Mars. Mars. Okay. Mars is the fourth planet from the sun. It is the second smallest planet in the solar system and is about the half the size of the earth. See, it is Mars. So which color it is? In red color. So that is why Mars is also called the red planet. Red planet. Okay. So we'll just see what is it. It is the fourth planet and it is the second smallest planet. First smallest planet is what? Mercury. After that, Mars. Mars is the second smallest planet in the solar system and is about the half the size of the Earth. When you compare to the size of our Earth, children, planet. So this Mars is about the half the size of the Earth. Okay, half the size of the Earth. So we'll just go back and see how it is, as we have there in the side. See, where is our planet? Here, Earth. Okay, so from this, if you compare the size, this is half the size of the Earth. Clear, children? Now, so this planet Mars is also called as red planet because the soil and rocks on its surface are red in color. So every planet has got some rocks and some materials, children, like soil, dust and everything. Okay. So On this planet, the soil and rocks on its surface are red in color. So that is why it looks red. And we call it as red planet. And Mars has two moons. So this planet has got two moons, whereas we Earth has got one moon. Okay, so Mars has got two moons. That is the speciality of the Mars. Okay, children? Now, so here is a fact, children. Let us just read it. The highest mountain in the solar system, called Olympus Mons, that is Mount Olympus, is on the surface of the planet Mars. It is about 3 times taller than the Mount Everest. See, children, in the world, the highest mountain on Earth is what? Mount Everest. Mount Everest, okay. But here, we have got one more highest mountain, that is about 3 times taller than the Mount Everest. And that highest mountain is where? In the solar system, and which we call it as Olympus Mons. Olympus Mons, that is Mount Olympus. Okay, children, so this mountain is located on the surface of Mars planet. Clear? Yes. And here one more information, children. Mangalayaan is the Indian's Mars orbiter mission, which was successfully launched on 5th November 2013 by the Indian Space Research Organization, that is ISRO. And it was launched from the Satish Dhawan Space Center, Sriharikota, Andhra Pradesh. See, children, how proud we must. So, our research persons from ISRO. Okay, ISRO is the Indian Space Research Organization, children, which are going to study about the planet solar system with the help of satellites. And we have got one space center in Andhra Pradesh. That is Satish Dhawan Space Center, which is located in Sriharikota. So from this center, so one mission was launched and it was very successful. And the Indian Mars orbiter mission, that is Mangalayaan, and this mission, it traveled into this planet Mars. It landed on this planet Mars and it was successfully launched on 5th November 2013, children. And on this, you also have a picture, a movie. They have released a movie on this subject, children. So if possible, just watch that movie. So you'll just know very clearly how the mission was started, how it had some problems to launch it successfully, and then how they overcome it, and they were successful in launching the mission on this planet Mars. Okay, children, now coming back to our lesson, we are going to learn about the Jupiter now. Jupiter is the 5th planet from the Sun and the largest planet in the solar system. So what is the largest planet, children? It is Jupiter, and it is the 5th planet from the Sun. Okay. And Jupiter is also the fastest spinning planet. Spinning is just taking rounds, spinning. No, when you throw a ball, it just spins. No, so this is also the fastest spinning planet. So it's going to rotate very fast. Okay, and because of its fast spin, the planet pulls the clouds surrounding it, because it is going to rotate very fast. The planet is going to pull the clouds surrounding it, it seems. See how nice it is? And this results in the formation of a stripped pattern on it. See here, stripped pattern. Are you able to see this rounds? See here, the pattern. So this is because of this fast spin, and the clouds are going to surround it, so we can see a stripped pattern on it. Now, are you able to see, children, here? Okay. And Jupiter has 67 known moons revolving around it. So great. Jupiter has 67 known moons revolving around it, it seems. See, 67 moons. So it has got revolving around it. So, children, so Jupiter is very special when compared to the other planets, because it is the fastest spinning planet, it is the largest planet in the solar system, and it has got 67 known moons. And the sixth planet is the Saturn, and it's very beautiful to see this planet, children. It is the second largest planet in the solar system. So after Jupiter, so solar in the largest planet position, Saturn is going to occupy the second place. Okay, and Saturn has a prominent ring system around it. See here, the ring, how beautiful it is. So it has got a prominent ring system around it. So it always has this ring around it, and it has 62 known moons revolving around it. Okay, and it has got 62 moons. And at the last, children, you have got Uranus and Neptune, the seventh and the eighth planet. So Uranus is the seventh planet, and it is the third largest planet in the solar system. First is Jupiter, second is Saturn, third is the Uranus. Okay, in size, the third largest planet in the solar system. And Neptune is the eighth and the farthest planet, because Neptune is very far away at the last. So it is very far away from the Sun. So it is the farthest planet, and it is the fourth largest planet in the solar system. Okay, and Uranus has about 27 known moons. So Uranus has got 27 known moons, and Neptune has around 14 known moons. See here, children, so how many moons have these planets have got? So Uranus has got 27 and Neptune has got 14 known moons. Clear, children? So this is what we have learnt about the planets. This is how they are. Okay, and this is all the features they have got. I hope you have understood this, children. And we also said we have got dwarf planets also in the solar system. No, so these are not big in size like our Jupiter, Saturn and all that. So they are very small planets, dwarf, very small. And a dwarf planet is an object that revolves around the Sun but does not belong to the category of planets. See here, so they also revolve around the Sun, but they do not belong to this planets group. Okay, so in 2006, the International Astronomical Union classified Pluto as a dwarf planet, though it was considered as a planet till 2006. So actually, children, so before 2006 or until 2006, we were having 9 planets. So even this planet, dwarf planet, that is Pluto, was also included as a planet. It was said as a planet and included in this planets category. But in 2006, what happened? This IAU, that is International Astronomical Union, people who the mission or the institute which measures the distance between the Sun and the satellites and the planets. Okay, so these people, they classified Pluto as a dwarf, very small planet. So though it was considered as a planet before, so these people, they named it as a dwarf planet, and they have removed this Pluto from the planet list. Okay, children, and Ceres, Makemake, Eris, etc., and there are some other dwarf planets in our solar system. So there are some more planets, children, which are there in our dwarf planets. Okay, in our solar system, see here, dwarf planets, how the pictures are there. So here you can see them very clearly, like Makemake, Ceres, Eris, Pluto, Maumee, and all these. So they are also planets, but they do not come under planets category, children. They are dwarf planets. So hope you have understood the lesson until now. Okay, we will be continuing with much more topics in the coming session. So until then, stay well, eat well, and take care of yourself, children. So goodbye. Please visit our website, www.aimstoday.in, For other information regarding online classes, quizzes, live worksheets, DIY activities, English classes and coding, thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for receiving latest updates.